Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss multiple choice questions from third chapter, pair of linear equations in two variables. These are very important questions and they were shared by government authorities from math department. Do watch complete video and subscribe my channel to get notifications. 10th question. In this model paper, pair of linear equations starts with 10th question. This question paper was shared by DDP office, Bangalore. The question says the lines represented by x plus 2y minus 4 is equal to 0 and 2x plus 4y minus 12 is equal to 0 represent what type of lines? In the graph, the pair of linear equations might be intersecting lines, parallel, coincident or perpendicular. So we have to check the types of lines. So to check the types of lines, we have to compare the ratios of the coefficients. I repeat once again, we have to compare the ratios of the coefficients. So the ratios of coefficients are a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2, where a1, a2 are the coefficient of x of first linear equation and second linear equation, b1, b2 are the coefficient of y of first equation and second linear equation, c1, c2 are the constant of first and second pair of linear equation. So what is a1? A1 is x coefficient of first equation. There is no coefficient, we will assume it as 1. A2 is 2. So b1 is 2 and b2 is 4. c1 is minus 4, c2 is minus 12. So we are comparing the ratios and we will simplify it in the lower part. Terms 2 1s are 2 2s are, negative negative cancel, 4 1s are 4 2s are. So all the ratios are equal. A1 by A2 is equal to 1 by 2, B1 by B2 is also equal to 1 by 2, C1 by C2 is also equal to 1 by 2. So these are the condition for what type of lines? Yes, this is the condition for pair of linear, this is the condition for coincident lines. So what type of lines are they? Coincident. So correct option for this question is C. You have to circle the C option. Next question. If the equations x plus 2y is equal to 3 and 2x plus 4y is equal to k are the coincident lines. In the previous question itself, we have seen the condition for coincident lines. Then find the value of k. So our target is to find the value of k in this pair of linear equations. And the condition is given is, the type of line they have given is coincident lines. What is the condition for the coincident line, students? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. We have to compare the ratios. So for your reference, I am going to say the other two lines conditions also. For intersecting lines, the condition is A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. And for parallel line, condition is A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 but not equal to C1 by C2. In this question, we will see only the coincident line condition. So coincident lines condition is A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, which is also equal to C1 by C2. So what is A1? A1 is nothing but x coefficient in first equation, which is 1, and A2 is the coefficient of x in the second equation, which is 2. Okay, is equal to B1. What is B1? Y coefficient. If you see here, B1 is 2 and B2 is coefficient of y in second equation, 4. And what is C1? C1 is 3 and C2 is k. So our target is to find the k. So what I will do is, I will take last two terms. Second, I will equate last two terms because k is there in the third term, as simple as that. When two fractions are equated, we have to do the cross multiplication, as you know. 2 into k is 2k and 4 into 3 is 12. I want the value of k and something is there with k. What is that? 2. What is the relation between 2 and k, students? Yes, multiplication. If there is no symbol, it means multiplication. If multiplication moves to that side, it will become division. So 12 by 2 is 6. So value of k is 6. You have to circle the correct option C. 6 is the answer. Moving on to the next question in pair of linear equation. The number of solutions to the pair of equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 6 and 3x plus 2y is equal to 9 are. So to find the number of solutions, we have to find the type of line. So we have three types of lines in pair of linear equation. One is intersecting, another is parallel, and third one is coincident. See, students, check properly, understand the concept clearly. In the previous two questions, this is the third question, we all have to apply the ratios of the coefficients. We have to compare the ratios of coefficients to find the solution. So let us discuss. So we have to compare the ratios of the coefficients a1 by a2, b1 by b2, and c1 by c2. So a1 by a2 is nothing but 2 by 3, b1 by b2 is nothing but 3 by 2, and c1 by c2 is 6 by 9. Clearly, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2 because 2 by 3 and 3 by 2 are not equal. So if a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, this is the condition for intersecting lines. So for intersecting lines, we have how many solutions, students? We have only one solution. Okay, so there is another name for one solution in mathematics, which is called unique solution. One and same. Sometimes they will give one, sometimes they will give unique word. So don't get confused. One and unique are one and same. So correct option for this question is one. Next question. X plus 2y is equal to 10 and x minus 2y is equal to 6. Find the value of x and y. To find the value of x and y for this pair of linear equations, we have to use elimination method. There are four ways actually. You can find graphical method, you can use substitution method, you can use cross multiplication method, but I prefer elimination method, which is the easiest of all the method. So I'm just using the elimination method. If elimination method means we have to eliminate either x or y. In this case, I'm eliminating y. Plus 2y minus 2y get cancelled. X plus x is 2x and 10 plus 6 is 16. I want the value of x, so x will be 16 by 2, which is nothing but 8. So once you know the value of 8, you can find the value of y by substituting x value in first equation. I am representing the above statement, above equation as 1 and below equation as 2. So first equation is x plus 2y is equal to 10. I'm replacing the value of x with 8 and remaining terms as it is. So as I want the value of y, I will send all the terms which are there in the left hand side. First I'm sending plus 8, it will become minus 8. So 2y is equal to 2, y will be 2 by 2, which is 1. So value of x is 8 and value of y is 1. Correct option for this question is 8 and 1, because they are asking to find x and y. So first x, which is 8, and second is y, which is 1. So correct option here is 8 and 1. Don't get confused, students, not 1 and 8, x 8, y 1. First question, the value of x and y which satisfy the linear equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 16r. So there are four options with x and y. In the first option, x is 5 and y is 2. To satisfy the linear equation, we have to replace the value of x and y and check whether left hand side and right hand side are equal. If it is satisfied, that means if LHS and RHS are equal, then that option is the correct one. Let us try with option A. I mean, we have to replace the value of x and y in linear equation. So given linear equation is 2x plus 3y is equal to 16. So I am replacing the option A values x as 5 and y as 2. 2 5s are 10, 3 2s are 6. 10 plus 6 is 16, which is RHS. I have taken the LHS part, I replaced x and y values and I got the value of left hand side as 16 and RHS is also 16. Therefore, option A is satisfying the linear equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 16. Therefore, correct option among A, B, C, D is A. And if you replace the value of B, C, D, they are not satisfying. We'll check with B, okay, whether the option B, x is equal to 2 and y is 5, is satisfying the linear equation or not. So 2x plus 3y, this value should be equal to 16 for option B. Let us replace the value of x with 2 and y with 5. 2 2s are 4. 3 5s are 15. 4 plus 15 is 19, which is not equal to RHS. RHS is 16 and LHS is 19. Therefore, option B is not satisfying the linear equation. Similarly, C and D won't be satisfying the linear equation. So, correct option for this question is A. Second question, by solving a pair of linear equation x plus y is equal to 8 and 2y minus x is equal to 1, we have to find the value of x and y. To solve the pair of linear equation, we have four methods which we have studied in the 10th class. One method is graphical method, second method is substitution method, third method is elimination method, and fourth method is cross multiplication method. And the most important and easy and preferable method is elimination method. I'm going to discuss how to solve the pair of linear equation with elimination method in this problem. So the two linear equations are x plus y is equal to 8 and 2x minus. So they are not in a standard form. So first I will make the second equation. I will put in a standard form. So minus x plus 2y is equal to 1. And I am going to eliminate either x or y in this pair of linear equation. So I am adding minus x and plus x will be cancelled. This is plus x and this is minus x. It is cancelled. Y plus 2y is equal to 3y. And right hand side 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. So 3y is equal to 9. Y will become 9 by 3, which is equal to 3. So value of y is 3. Means 3 times 3 is 9. And I am going to substitute the value of y in either first equation or second equation. Okay. I am going to substitute value of y in first equation. If you replace even in second equation, you will get the same value of x. So x plus y is equal to 8. I am going to replace the value of y as 3, which we solved just now, which is nothing but 8. So x is equal to 8 minus 3. I want the value of x, so I am sending the plus 3 to other side, will become minus 3. X is equal to 5. So the correct option among this four choices are x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 3. Correct option is fourth question. Find the pair of coincident lines in the following. To find the pair of coincident lines, we have to compare the ratios of the coefficients of each pair of linear equations among A, B, C, D options. So students, what is the coincident line condition? We all know that coincident line condition is A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, which is also equal to C1 by C2. Now we are going to compare the ratios A1 by A2, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2. In the first option A1 by A2, where A1 and A2 are the quotient of x of first equation and quotient A2 is the quotient of x with second equation, which is nothing but 1 by 3. B1 by B2 is minus 2 by 4 and C1 by C2 is 0 by 20. Clearly A1 by A2 value 1 by 3 and B1 B2 minus 2 by 4 are not equal. So if therefore first equation is not the correct option for the coincident line. So we are moving, we will check with the second option, option B. So we also compare the ratios with second option, A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. A1 by A2 in the pair of linear equation is 2 by 4, B1 by B2 is 3 by 6 and C1 by C2 is 9 by 18. So clearly, A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2 are equal to each other. So therefore, the ratios of their comparison of the terms will be A1 by A2, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2. So correct option for this question is B. Let us discuss the first problem in mathematics model paper. If a pair of linear equations 3x plus 2ky is equal to 2 and 2x plus 5y plus 1 is equal to 0 are parallel, then find the value of k. Let us take the pair of linear equations 3x plus 2ky is equal to 2 and 2x plus 5y is equal to minus 1. Let us keep this in a standard form and representing this pair of linear equation in terms of the coefficients, a1 is 3, B1 is 2k and C1 is equal to 2. And quotients of second equation will be A2 is equal to 2, B2 will be the quotient of y, which is 5, and C2 is equal to minus 1. We have to know the parallel line condition. Parallel condition is A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2. You will take the first ratio of first two and replace their values. So A1 by A2 will be 3 by 2, A1 is 3, A2 is 2, is equal to B1 by B2, B1 is 2k and B2 is 5. So 2k by 5. And we will do the simple cross multiplication. 3 5s are 15, is equal to 2k into 2 is 4k. So they are asking to find the value of k, k will be 15 by 4. Correct option here is A. So we are going to share the correct option for the first question, which is, we'll see the second question. The pair of equations 2x minus 5y plus 4 is equal to 0 and 2x plus y minus 8 is equal to 0 as. To find the number of solutions, we have to check the what type of lines are there. To check the type of lines, we have to compare their ratios. So A1 by A2, B1 by B2 and C1 by C2. Where A1 is the quotient of x and A2 is the quotient of x for second equation, B1 is the quotient of y for first equation and B2 is the quotient of y for the second equation. So there is no number, we will assume as 1. Clearly 2 by 2 and minus 5 by 1 are not equal. So A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. These are the condition for intersecting lines. So we all know that the intersecting lines has only one solution. So correct option for this question is one solution. One solution is nothing but a unique solution. They are synonyms. We are going to share the option C for second question. Third question, the value of x and y when a point lies on a linear equation 2x minus 3y is equal to 12. So to check this problem, we have to replace the value of x and y in the linear equation, and if LHS is equal to RHS, then the point lies on the equation. Otherwise, it is not satisfying. We have to go with the other option. Let us replace x value is equal to 0 and y value is minus 3 in the linear equation 2x minus 3y is equal to 12. So first option is x is equal to 0 and y is equal to minus 3. We will replace in the linear equation. 2 into 0, x value is given as 0. 3 into minus 3, y value is given as minus 3. 2 times 0 is 0. Negative into negative is positive. 3 threes are 9, which is equal to 12. 0 plus 9 is 9, is equal to 12. This is not satisfying the equation. So option A is not the correct answer. We will check with option C. We are going to replace the value of x and y in the same linear equation. X value is given as 3 and I am replacing the value of x as 3 and y value is given as minus 2 and our answer should be RHS 12. 2 3s are 6, 3 minus into minus is plus, 3 2s are 6. 6 plus 6 is 12, which is right hand side. Therefore LHS is equal to RHS and this point x is equal to 3 and y is equal to minus 2 is satisfying the linear equation 2x minus 3y is equal to 12. Therefore x3y minus 2 is a point lies on the linear equation.